Hey guys, and welcome back to part 3 of our Wood PC Kit series. If you haven't seen part 1 or 2 yet, make sure to check them out, the link down below. Today, we're going to show you how to create a side panel like this one. It has its own mounting mechanism, a wooden panel at the bottom, and of course, it's going to include some milling. So let's get started. So let's jump directly into Fusion 360 and take a look at the 3D models for our PC. To create the airflow inside the case, we're going to make a little gap between the side panels and the frame of the case. In order to achieve this gap, we're going to 3D print 4 small standoffs for each side panel. They will hold magnets inside so that the side panel can be attached very easily, and attach some felt pins on top to prevent scratching for the glass windows. The side panel consists of two parts, a wooden board for covering the lower chamber of the PC where all the cabling and the power supply is located. The base part will be transparent and has 4 holes that will be holding the magnets. On the bottom, we will remove 3 mm of the material to attach to the wooden panel. After taking a look at our simulation and see that everything works, we'll now go and mill it. We are once again going to use the Datron ML Cube CNC machine at our makerspace, the Grand Garage. So first, we need to set up the vacuum table before we can insert the workpiece. The glass part itself will be made out of leftover macrolone that we found. Macrolone is a robust and lightweight polycarbonate that has glass-like transparency and is impact resistant. So now that we have finished milling the macrolone, the next step is to cut out the wooden covers. And that's what it finally looks like.
It's time for assembly. First, we need to put the magnets inside the holes. So after a little bit of testing, we found out that the 4 magnets on the side panel won't be strong enough to hold it to the case. So we came up with another mounting mechanism.
We're now using screws at the top of the side panels to attach them to the frame. To make the screws work, we need to create new standoffs so they can fit through. We also need to put a thread insert into the frame, so we can actually screw the side panel to the case. For that, we're now going to drill 2 more holes on each side and glue them in. We're mixing up some epoxy glue to keep them in place. We've now also drilled these holes completely through so the screw can fit. The bottom still has the magnets so the side panel gets pulled to the case. To prevent the screws from scratching the glass, we're going to create some inserts. For 3D printing these rubber inlets, we use TPU 95 filament, which is a high quality flexible material. For the bottom standoffs, we need to glue the magnets in and apply some felt pads. So when we took a closer look at our 2 macrolone plates, we noticed that one of them had a lot of scratches, more than we actually wanted in our final piece. So we cut out another piece from the leftovers and made a 3rd side panel. Since we don't want to throw away the scratch piece, we're now going to try out the new sandblasting machine at our makerspace. We're going to cut out a sticker with our silhouette cameo and attach it to the scratch panel before blasting it, to try and add our logo. We're also going to add another one at the backside, just in case. So let's go and test out the sandblaster. So Sadly, we cannot achieve a perfectly even effect because we don't have the right blasting material.
You can see here, we have sandblasted at the back and actually had a sticker here so that this part is spared. And on the front side, we still have the sticker to have some kind of 3D effect. But what we do have is just two of the wooden plates. So we kind of need to decide if we want to have the back panel to be transparent or a little bit opaque with our Mob Bros logo inside. So what would you do? Tell us in the comments down below. We can already finish one of them. So let's finish the first wooden plate and put it on this side here. After putting in all the metal parts and making this beautiful side panel work, we actually need to install all the hardware parts and see if everything fits. And then, of course, we need to make the wooden panel all around it. So stay tuned for the next video and subscribe to our channel because you don't want to miss it. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it, and see you guys next time!